Welcome to today's lecture. Dear students, today we are going to discuss the life and career of one of the greatest dramatists, not only in English literature, but also in world literature, that is George Bernard Shaw, famously known as G.B. Shaw. As you know that G.B. Shaw was born in Dublin, it's a city in Ireland. He was born in 1856. And after Ireland, he shifted to Great Britain and lived there for many years of his life. Still today, Shaw is famous for his greatest play entitled as Pygmalion. As we know that Pygmalion has been translated into many languages. Pygmalion is also translated into Marathi under the title Ti Fulurani. So Pygmalion is the immortal and the most prestigious literary text created by George Bernard Shaw. It is the story of a Cockney girl. Cockney is a language in England. It's a local language, just like Ahirani. There's a Cockney girl who learns the RP English, that is stylish English, under the guidance of a teacher, that is Henry Higgins. Right. A film was also created based on the script of Pygmalion, and that is My Fair Lady. It's in a film. So the literary career of G.B. Shaw is of high quality. G.B. Shaw is considered as next to Shakespeare. I know that Shakespeare is the greatest dramatist in the world. But who is the number two? Who is the next to Shakespeare? It is none other than George Bernard Shaw. Initially, George Bernard Shaw's family background was not very supportive. Right. And he suffered through many familial loss, many financial losses also. This is his bedroom. You can see the image over here. And this place, the garden is there. One of the farmers you can see. He said that this is the favorite bench of G.B. Shaw, where he created many his literary works, many literary texts like drama. He did it over here. Right? It was used to be his favorite place. This is another favorite place, that is a harbor, a bandarahi. It is said that G.B. Shaw used to sit over here and he just tried to think over his texts. He created many texts by sitting over here. As you know that as a boy, young George led a troubled life. His father was an alcoholic, which turned his son into a teetotaler. His father was a lout, which turned his son into a cynic. Because of his alcoholism, G.B. Shaw became cynic. Cynic means short-tempered, right? A person who is having negative attitude like that. His father was a wife batterer who beats the wife, which turned his son into a pacifist. Actually, we can say that the disturbed family life of George Bernard Shaw impact negatively in the mindset of Shaw. Shaw's father died in 1885, right? See the anger. Neither his children nor his wife attended the funeral. So that we can imagine what kind of relationship might have been between a husband and wife, between a father and a son. So his father, in a short way, we can call him a cruel type of person. And it impacted deeply the mind of G.P. Shaw. Shaw had two sisters, right? And because of the father's behavior, the family suffered poverty. The financial position of the family was not good. And they have to live in Dublin, a city in Ireland. When Shaw was just 16 years of age, his mother died. That was a big shock to G.P. Shaw. Left her husband and son and moved regularly to London. Right? Shaw remained in Dublin with his father in order to finish school. Your father, right? This is the picture of G.P. Shaw in his youth. Shaw got his education in Wesley Connection School, right? He attended Dublin's Central Model School also. Shaw, in his adulthood, when he was just a young man, joined his sister and mother in London. He did not return to Ireland for nearly 30 years. So most of his life he spent in England. In London, he lived off his mother and sister while pursuing a career in journalism and writing. So at first, he wrote prose, completing 5 novels before any of them were published. So in the beginning, he started his career as a novelist. But unfortunately, none of his early novels attracted the attention of the people. So as a novelist, George Bernard Shaw was flopped. Shaw then continued his education. Then he visited British Museum also. He published his first novel, that is Immaturity. Right. But as I told you that it was just a flop text. He was basically a vegetarian, right, who did not like alcoholism and tobacco. Right. He created Fabian Society. Fabian Society is associated with George Bernard Shaw. Fabian Society means the particular type of writing style. Right. So G.P. Shaw, as we know, when we discuss the concept of problem play, we come to know that G.P. Shaw's writing of problem play is quite different from other playwrights like John Galsworthy, like Henry Ibsen. So he created his own theater, that is Fabian Society. And his dramas basically concentrated on socialism. So he studied society. Society is the best of his dramas. And the other famous members of the Fabian Society were H.G. Wells and other prominent thinkers of his current days, contemporary days. He served on the executive committee of the society, which would be instrumental in founding the London School of Economics. So these were the initial years of George Bernard Shaw. You can see the images. So George Bernard Shaw struggled a lot and when he achieved his 50 years of age, he started getting popularity. See the essays written by George Bernard Shaw. You can see the year 1889. The Fabian essays. See the base, that is socialism. He saw in his 50 plus age. So it is said that George Bernard Shaw used to stand on the street corner and used to start the speeches. Initially, people just assumed him to be a madman. A person who just chats continuously, standing at the corner of some street. But after some days, after some months, the people start recognizing the truth and the arguments in the words of J.B. Shaw. So he wrote his first play, that is Widower's Houses. As you know that Shaw's plays basically have social criticism. So it is about slum lords, slums, property, right? The problem of slums, the environment in the slum area, their lifestyles, all these things are highlighted in Widower's Houses. The play attacked savagely by people who opposed his politics. As you know that J.B. Shaw basically highlighted socialism in this drama. You know, socialism means equal justice to each and everybody, equal scope to each and everybody, right? Equal sharing of profit in the society, that's it. And the so-called rich, the high-class people opposed this kind of thinking of J.B. Shaw. So it was then that Shaw knew he was a good playwright. When Shaw received criticism from the high class society, from the rich society, from the exploiting society, right, he considered it as a praise and he assumed that he was just a good playwright. He was starting to upset so many people with his social comment. So many famous things, many known facts are criticized by J.B. Shaw on the stage. Right? And he received in the beginning many social commentaries, many social negative comments. He went on to revolutionize the English theater by concentrating his writing on various social issues. At a time when most other playwrights were writing sentimental, right? Type of drama. So we can say that in England, it was just J.B. Shaw who wrote on social issues. And the social issues were neglected by other playwrights. That's a remarkable thing. What happened in 1898? He moved out of his mother's house, right? And he married Charlotte, an Irish woman, right? But in 1943, Charlotte was no more. Then J.B. Shaw married again. Shaw, who never believed in the institution of a personal hero, wrote of his own terrible adventure anonymously in the manner of a farce and sent to the local tabloids. He himself did not believe in the concept of marriage. And why? Because of his mother's and father's sad married life. These are some pics from his personal life where he spent some of his moments. One small house is there, you can see it's a cottage. Church is there. Later on, he published his dramas, right? Entitled as Mad and Superman, then John Bull's and Other Island, Major Barbara, right? These are his remarkable dramas. He also wrote a play during the World War First, that is Heartbreak House. One more thing is that the dramas of Shaw had a preface. Preface means introductory information. Right. So before going to watch his drama, the audience has to go through the preface. Has to go through the introductory information. For example, Pygmalion. So the viewers, the audience has to go through a preface, right? So introductory information in order to understand the theme of the drama. So each and every drama by G.P. Shaw has a preface, that is an introductory information. Without reading the preface, the audience feels it quite difficult to understand the drama. So all these things make G.P. Shaw a very special type of dramatist. As we discussed, G.P. Shaw did not believe in art for art's sake. He believed in art for the sake of society. So G.P. Shaw's main intention is that literature is not just piece of entertainment, it is for social criticism. And he used his pen, used his dramatic skill to highlight the social problems in the society. So many local as well as universal problems are highlighted on the stage through G.P. Shaw's pen. Many delicate topics like prostitution, marriage, these and many other topics are presented successfully by George Bernard Shaw. This is the old age picture. You can see many intellectual people along with G.P. Shaw. We need not to go into details. It was the bedroom where he took his last breath at the age of 94, and he died in 1950. And the reason was due to a fall from a ladder. And his house is restored as a museum even today. These are some pics from his dramas. My Fair Lady, right? It's the film based on Pygmalion. It is translated into Marathi, People Running. So here, let's stop our discussion. We continue in our next.